At the intersection of Pulteney Street and North Terrace, Bonython Hall stands as a stout example of early 20th century neo-Gothic architecture. To the sum of £50,000, architect Walter Hervey, with input from Sir Langdon Bonython, from which the hall derives its name, sought to bring Adelaide Uni a hall that would be reminiscent of old English universities. Its facade is framed by two large bell towers, and, in typical Gothic style, its entrance is fronted by three large arcades whose wooden doors are crowned with a row of decorative crenellations and two statued lions which bear the University of Adelaide's crested shield, a testament to the type of heraldry typically seen in medieval castles. Its north-to-south orientation, as well as its symmetrical design, are also seen in many of the cathedrals of the medieval period. Supporting steel and concrete buttresses allow for the hall's vaulted roof and ornate stained glass windows. The textured walls are made from local Murray Bridge freestone, and the slate for its roof dug from the Willunga quarries. Bonython Hall exemplifies a perfect marriage of contemporary and medieval design. Bonython Hall's three-year construction began in 1933 and was financed primarily by a £50,000 donation by Sir John Langdon Bonython. It is rumoured that one purpose for the building's creation was to guarantee the beauty of the university by halting the convergence of Pulteney and Frome Street, which would divide the university campus. Bonython's insistence that the construction adhere to a Gothic style can also be seen in some of his wider philanthropic endeavours, such as the original proposal for the Parliament House, to which he donated £100,000. The construction of many Gothic buildings within Adelaide served as a romanticism of the past, and the colossal structures built over generations that provided such a marvel to society. Divide over the location of the hall played out in the press and Parliament, but ultimately, Bonython Hall was built in the proposed location of Pulteney Street to Frome Road, preserving the beauty of Adelaide University. The first stone was laid by Sir Langdon Bonython on the 4th of December 1933, and the building was finalised in 1936. It is said that the Bonython family was very conservative, hence why the floor is at a slope to discourage dancing. The primary use of the hall today is to hold the University of Adelaide's graduations, as it boasts a large audience capacity on top of its spectacle. Sir John Langdon Bonython's donation gifted the University of Adelaide what was referred to as a Great Hall from the European medieval period. During the Middle Ages, Great Halls were found in royal palaces, castles, and manor houses throughout most of northwestern Europe. The Great Halls of the medieval era were relatively homogeneous in regards to layout. Rectangular in shape, they were several times longer than they were wide. Furthermore, the rooms typically featured vaulted ceilings to facilitate a spacious environment. This allowed for a form of a balcony on the entry portion to the room, often referred to as the minstrel's gallery. These balconies typically served as performance platforms for entertainers and musicians, as their sight would be somewhat obscured from the guests below. Beneath the balcony was a passageway that granted entrance into the hall, and opposite that passage, on the other side of the hall, was the dais. During the medieval era, the dais referred to a part of the floor at the end of the hall, which was raised by a step above the rest of the room. It was here that the master of the household dined with his associates at a high table. As the other guests occupied the lower, central area of the room, emphasis was placed upon the lord and the honoured guests. This dais area typically possessed its own passageway for private admission, along with deep, recessed bay windows that provided optional privacy. While the resurgence of interest in medievalism during the late 19th and early 20th century brought the form of these great halls back into vogue, they no longer play the same role as their inspirations. Bonython Hall has, ever since construction, functioned primarily as a centre for graduation ceremonies, examinations, and public speaking events.